policy, and this is basically the introductory paragraph from that policy. I won't talk too much about it, but the Australian rice industry cares about and depends on a healthy environment. Water, soil, air, habitat, and local communities are fundamental resources for the industry and the broader community. And with rice, obviously, we use a lot of irrigation water, and when that's handled, our irrigation water was handled badly. It did cause some problems, environmental problems. Today, there's probably two reasons we do it very well. One is too expensive to waste, but the other, we care for our environment. So just some brief messages here for those who don't know it. The rice growers get their water last as general security water users. And this is, that's blatantly obvious this year with a 4% allocation. They receive their water after towns, high security and stock invested users. Australian grown rice uses less water than any country on earth, and it's 50% less than the global average per tonne of grain produced. Australian rice growers use recycle systems, so any water that comes off the crop is reused back on the crop or for another crop or pasture. Rice soils are tested to ensure they limit water table sessions. Rice water use is monitored annually by irrigation supply companies to ensure that no excess amounts of water is used or affects water tables. Rice growers utilise the stored subsoil moisture to grow another crop post-harvest. And growers today are producing up to, well, our yields today are even higher than 12 tonne in many cases, but they're producing up to 12 tonne of rice and 4 tonne of wheat from 10 to 14 megalitres of water that was actually applied to the rice crop. So it's a significant amount of food grain gets produced from that one rice crop, the water that was supplied to the first rice crop. Just a bit about rice and soil. In a rice situation, the stubble, if you grow a 10 tonne rice crop, you've got about 15 tonne of rice stubble on the surface, but below that, to support that, there's a massive root structure. There's just a photo just demonstrating this is actually mulched rice straw, but it's just, if you can see it clearly, you can see the root mass that's underneath the rice crop. And the organic matter benefits post-rice are enormous to our clay soils. In terms of ecosystem services, you'll probably hear a little more about that, and I don't want to dwell on it. The rice itself obviously supports many species, and I think Matt might mention a few of those later. And also within the irrigation infrastructure, those structures support a lot of species on the farm. But I'll let Matt talk about that a little bit further. In terms of the rice industry, we're always embarking on research. Some of this is about stubble management. We're trying to find ways to use our stubble and not burn it. In this particular case, this is a trial at Rice Research Australia, where we're trying to establish some data on greenhouse gas emissions from rice. So I'll throw that one in for you. So yeah, I believe it. Rice does deliver a reasonably significant environmental bottom line. Riverina rice and the social bottom line, in addition to farm employees, Sunrise employs 2,100 people across 9 businesses. I will point out some of those people are employed internationally, not just in Australia, but it's a significant employer. The industry has community support through rural leadership programs that we run. It offers tertiary education scholarships for young men and women. It offers farm business management training through rice extension programs and the environmental champions programs. Community group support through the environmental champions program. This is similar and part of why I'm here today, but working with Western Murray Land Improvement Group is part of that community group support. We obviously have ag extension delivery, as I mentioned, Troy being present today. We deliver natural resource management programs for community members. At the moment, linking back to the previous speakers, we're developing our vegetation corridor plan for the West Berrigan Irrigation District. So hopefully we can have some ready-to-go projects to look for funding for next year after we finish that plan. Resources for education programs in the Solomon Islands, the True Care program in Papua New Guinea, promoting healthy eating and living. These are areas where our industry supplies, and in the case of we're getting meals and rice, and they play a key part in those communities. So I think I could justify that rice delivers a social bottom line. In terms of economics, it's Sunrise, the company, actually, the turnover this year was well in excess, I think it was $1.3 billion. But in after from this last 2014, 1,500 growers grew rice in the Riverina with $330 million returned to them in paddy punters. So that's money back into your local communities to be spent. Within Australia, largely, if you've gone on holidays, I've heard, so they must have done okay, but it's great to see that much money coming back to the farm gate. I won't dwell on the fact, I've actually covered the second paragraph there. The Sunrise net profits this year, this is all taken from this year's annual profit annual report, is $49 million. The shareholders in Sunrise currently are B-class shareholders, and that comprise past and present growers. You have to have been a grower to be a shareholder in, have to be or have been a grower to be a shareholder in Sunrise at the moment. So as it was, they've all received a significant fully franked dividend this year as well. Sunrise exports food to around 60 countries in the world, and every day there's 20 million people eat rice that's been produced in Australia. So obviously that's a significant economic benefit to our country with so much export income returning back to Australia. As I said, 80% of rice is exported, and I must point out that doesn't happen in drought years. And this year at the annual conference we received sponsorship by the Port of Melbourne Authority to tour the port facilities, and it was quite a fascinating experience, but what was clearly pointed out to us that rice and Sunrise is the fourth largest container exporter out of that port, and Melbourne Port is the biggest port in the country. So yeah, I believe it does, rice does deliver an economic bottom line. I have got a